Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here, and thanks for tuning in. Now, over my years of fish keeping, something I've definitely learned to be true is that fish have personalities. Every fish is different, and sometimes it's important to learn the habits and temperaments of your fish in order to provide the proper care for them. Now, from time to time, you're going to come across a fish that simply won't work out in your tank, whether it be too shy, too aggressive, or simply has a taste for coral. Ultimately, that fish needs to be removed for the sake of the community in your tank. In this video, we're going to show you guys how to use a fish trap and provide some helpful tips that will take the headaches out of catching that pesky fish in your reef. The fish trap we have here at Marine Depot is one of the most effective fish traps I have come across, and we carry two different sizes. The smaller size measures 6 inches by 3 inches by 3.5 inches and is perfect for smaller reef fish like chromis, clownfish, wrasses, and damsels. The larger size measures 8 inches by 6 inches by 6 inches and is great for larger wrasses, dwarf angels, and even smaller tangs. The traps have a removable bait container that holds food to bait the fish and is awesome because you can refill it without moving the trap. The strong suction cup will hold the fish trap against your tank wall, making it easy to set in place without the worry of damaging anything in your tank. When placing the fish trap, you'll want to set it in a location where the fish will naturally feed and notice the food easily. For fish that feed higher up in the water column, you'll probably want to suction cup the trap to the side of your tank. And for fish that are bottom dwelling, you'll want to place the trap on the sand bed. After placing the trap, fill the bait holder with the fish's favorite food, remove the door altogether, and walk away. The trap will most likely intimidate fish in your tank and may take them a few hours or even a couple of days to actually feed from the bait holder, so I found it best to just wait and not set the trap until you have observed the targeted fish feeding from inside the trap. This is especially important for finicky fish, as the more aggressive fish in your tank will probably go for the food right away. Once you have observed the targeted fish feeding from the bait holder, it is time to set the trap and make your move. The fish traps have a sliding door along with a fishing line attached to a small piece of acrylic. You will need to set the door open using a small piece of acrylic and align it with the groove on the sliding door. Then find yourself a comfy chair, grab the fishing line, and wait. Once the fish is observed feeding inside the trap, pull the line and the sliding door will close and trap the fish inside. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that this is easy and works every time. A lot of times it's going to take a few tugs on the fishing line to be successful, but be persistent. I can tell you from personal experience that it's quite satisfying to finally catch that pesky fish that's been wreaking havoc in your reef tank. Now, you can pick up one of these clever fish traps by visiting our website or following the link in the video description below. If you found this video helpful, please like and share it to help us spread the word. We do appreciate all of you for watching, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.